guys, welcome back to Embers and Ash. My name's Ashley, if you didn't know. Today I'm following along with my Christmas themed videos, and today's topic is gift ideas for the person who has everything, or also the minimalist. So I've compiled a list of things that I think I would give as gifts to people, but everyone's different. You might not like these ideas. I really am just hoping that this might give you some inspiration because I feel like I have a few unique ones in here. So yeah, let's get started. So the first gift idea is supplies for a charcuterie board. So I know it's common to give like wooden cutting boards or charcuterie boards as gifts, but I think it's also really fun to actually give the food supplies. So you can either go perishable or non-perishable. I'm going more non-perishable. So like olive oils, balsamics, jams, olives, salsas, just kind of a variety of things like that, especially if you can find like really unique ones, not just like your average supermarket supplies. I think that's a really fun gift to give someone. It's also a great gift because it's a consumable and you can often find it zero waste. Oh, and if you're a family member watching this, maybe don't, because there's a chance that you might get one of these gifts. The second gift idea is to give someone two empty growlers and a gift card to a brewery. I don't know what it's like where you live, but we have a lot of breweries in the Lower Mainland in BC, and I feel like it's so much more fun instead of giving someone just a gift card to somewhere, but actually giving them growlers to fill themselves with their favorite beer. I don't know, I thought it'd be a fun idea. Tip number three is to make a potpourri recipe for someone. I've been wanting to do this for a long time because there's so many cute recipes online and you just fill all this stuff in these little jars and it's so cute and it's zero waste and it smells amazing, and I think it's the perfect gift for anyone because who wouldn't want that, right? The fourth gift is a cozy blanket, especially in the winter time. Maybe this is more of a gift for girls, because I know how girls are. We just love our cozy blankets, and as long as it's soft and big and fluffy, I think they're gonna love it. The fifth tip is nostalgic food or candy. This one's really fun for your nostalgic friends that are always talking about their childhood and how things used to be. Getting them something that maybe isn't as easily accessible anymore, or that's gone off the market. A fun candy or food idea, I find, can bring a lot of excitement out of someone. The sixth gift is a certificate to a spa or to a massage parlor. I know one person in my life who would hate it, and everyone else I'm sure can use a massage, because often it's not something that you would ever spend your own money on, and it's not something you would ever think of to go out and do, but if you have a certificate, then you get to go out and have a relaxing evening to yourself. The next suggestion is if it's someone who really like doesn't want anything, they have all they need, they don't want any junk, they don't want any food, maybe give a charitable donation in their name so that you're still showing that you care for this person and you want to do something for them, but you're doing something for others for them. Right? Did that make sense? The next one is a DNA test to Ancestry or one of those other brands. This one I find is really fun because people often won't do it because it costs a little bit of money, but everyone's kind of curious, right? Even if you know your heritage is exactly from one place, you're always wondering if there's some sneaky guy who got in the mix and screwed things up. So, I don't know, I think it would be really fun to do. And the last one, which is not really a great one to end on because it's very blah, but I think it would be a fun gift, is a hummingbird feeder. These things are pretty cheap, and I don't know, it's just something that I would never think of buying myself, but if I got it, it'd be so cool because you just hang them outside your window and hummingbirds come and hang out at your house. So I just thought that's something I would enjoy getting as a gift randomly. So yeah, that's the last one I'm ending on. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you might like my previous Christmas videos. My last one was where I made a macrame Christmas stocking, if you're interested. I really hope you enjoyed this one, and I'll catch you in the next one.